on the University, and we focused on the skull and bones, all right? And what I found out, I did some research, I had a whole lot of documentation, and I found out that there's several secret societies up there at Yale University, you know? And this led, I think, to Gene Crow. There's many of them. And most of your newscasters, politicians, captains of industry, CEOs, bank presidents, most of the prestigious people that come out of these top universities, and they're set up inside the university that they're set up in one of these societies. The top one being the Stolen Bones, which Bush came out of that, all right? You don't find out that this, but you just can't make it. If you're a genius and they don't want you to make it, you're not going to make it. You can be the stupidest person in the world and become the president. I mean, look at Bush. You can be an idiot. Look at Obama, man. That shows you that there's people behind the scenes of a thing called a secret government or the shadow government. All right?
And the fruits that thy soul lusted after are departed from thee, is that the American construction, which there's no fruit on the table. The ones that benefit the most from America is who? The so-called Jew. Alright? It's not just New York that's named Hymietown, right? But America is Hymieville, right? The so-called Jews benefit off America, right? And they always have. And the fruits that thou so lusted after are departed from thee, and all things which were dainty and goodly are departed from thee, and thou shalt find them no more at all. This is after America's destruction. The merchants of these things, which are so-called Jews, the biggest merchants of these things, which were made rich by them. So you got rich off of misery. And you have the nerve to set up some goddamn monument like my destiny of peace. That's gonna please too, you know?
And then the article that I don't know if you read it earlier about Aetna, the insurance company, they had a nerve to so-called apologize for their role in insuring slaves, you know? Your apology is not going to be enough. The only thing that's going to be enough is when you go into slavery, you actually pay for the crimes that you committed. That's when it's going to be forgiven, so to speak. Now, Renard says, the merchant of these things, which the main merchants are the international bunker families, which happen to live outside of America, and they're going to witness America's destruction, because they're going to be the first ones going into slavery. The first crop of our slaves, guess what, are so-called Jews. Those are the international bankers' families. The merchants of these things, which were made rich by her, shall stand afar off for the fear of her torment, weeping and wailing. Alright, so there it is right there. After America's destruction, the first ones that's going to be weeping and wailing are these bankers' families. Because they're going to go right into slavery. Alright? That's going to be hard for y'all because y'all people don't know what a lot of these work is. These are so-called Jewish bankers, the Illuminati's. Okay, Illuminati's. These elite ones, so-called elite ones, they never had a hard time in their life. They can ruin everything. So, since the 1700s, since the 1600s, shit really taking place since the 1400s. Because the bourgeois family, the 1400s, and the bourgeois are really the so-called Jews. That's really the Rothschilds. The Rothschilds changed their name. The boy we found that out was dead. The boy there's name has to be the Rothschild family. We didn't find money. Because they're so-called Jews. Their original last name was Langola. And all it always brings out the fact that you have the Langs, you know, the Langsons and all that. Those are all families and offshoots of the Rothschild because you have the Rockefellers. Now, the Rockefellers are nothing but Rothschilds that change their name to make it sound more Americanized.
Yeah. The Rockefellers are of the Rothschild family. Now, they're the same family except with different groups to throw the people up, right? Why do you think the Rockefellers are so on top of the list? Because they're really of the Rothschild line, right? Okay. Numbers 24 and 18. is that if he shall be a possession, still also shall be a possession. For his enemies of Israel shall be violent. Out of Jacob shall come he that shall have dominion, and shall destroy him that remaineth of the city. So when you look down at everyone, I'm saying that I know he starts off with the elect. If I start off with the elect, who's the elect? The 144,000. If I start off with them, and the future of all Israel about the elect, but the elect is going to be the one that's going to partake in the peace. First, man. This is one of our first ones. It says, when you look down at Amalek, He took up his parable and said, the elect are the ones that's going to be violent, man. They aren't stopping to say, yeah, remember that. He says, and when he looked on Amalek, he took up his parable and said, Amalek was the first of the nations, but his latter end shall be that he perished forever. He was the first of the nations. That's why these so-called Jews are on the top of everything, man. Just the 1400s, they were everything. That they were on the top. These so-called Jews, that's why others even had spoken. Because they got it, because they're back to the universe now. But they're in here, they're going to go over the first to go into slavery.